ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, and this is Reagan.
Prime Minister, this concludes the honor. Oh. He said he hoped the future would unfold itself in ways which would make Pakistan and the United States comrades in the noble task of maintaining peace and in translating a great constructive dream. Freedom unleashes the creative spirit of the human spirit and carries the nation to its great potential. Pakistan has demonstrated this by its impressive rate of real economic growth, about 6% annually. No more of an enlightened individual can ignore it. But through it all, the courageous people of Pakistan and their government have remained stalwart in their opposition to the Soviet Union's brutal aggression. America deeply admires Pakistan's steadfastness and bravery in this noble saint, yes, who had fled their country, the single largest of Islamic hospitality. United States is proud to be assisting you in this most humanitarian enterprise. Your outstanding, or even more impressive, some might even say amazing, in light of the defense and refugee burden that we put on the exchange. These talks give us an opportunity to reaffirm our commitment to stand together.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Mr. President,
reciprocate these sentiments. I bring to you their cordial greetings and best wishes. For me personally, this visit to the United States is an occasion of inspiration, an essential part of Islamic belief. Even when we have faced difficult circumstances, demonstrated our commitment to the democratic process. My government has since restored the confidence of Pakistan and gratified that the transition from martial law to constitutional rule has been accomplished in peace and stability. Thank you for your concern in the face of the problems that confront us. In our struggle to safeguard principles, indispensable for the maintenance of freedom, with the leader of a long experience, I am confident that our talks would serve even mutual understanding and further promote cooperation and the members of our cross. Look forward keenly. Meeting American people in different walks of life. Once again, I thank you, Mr. President.
license.
And then we'll have to just things without them coming.
Yeah, that's fine.
Mr. President, are you going to negotiate a new test ban treaty with the Soviets, as they have said today?
I'm not going to take any questions here, any answers at this meeting. We have plenty of time. We'll be talking about that.
You'd like to talk about the helicopters to Bolivia. Is that in our national security interest?
Anything we do is in our national security interest.
Mr. Prime Minister, does your country have the atomic bomb?
I think we talked later on that, as the President has earlier mentioned to you.
Thank you. Take a chair left, please.
You can reply today. There was no need to ask me.
Who
just come with us, yes. I would like to... gained a good experience for the photographic.
Yes.
Of Pakistan, I've been extremely busy in my country, and I was really delighted when I received your invitation. The first opportunity I got, I said I must come and visit you, meet you personally, and talk to you about the problems we are facing in our region. And I have brought my friend and members of the delegation. I would like to introduce you today. You know, on the right, Sanjata Yakub Khan, he's the Foreign Minister of Pakistan. And second, sir, Mr. Mohammed Nawaz Sharif, he's the Chief Minister of Punjab Province, sir. One of the biggest provinces of Pakistan, sir. We have the majority of population. Next, sir, you know, our ambassador here.
Yes.
And next to him, Mr. Markerson, he's the new ambassador who will be now taking over the United States from Pakistan. My left, I have Mr. Ramazan Singh, he's the finance minister of Pakistan. he took over after we lifted the Martian Guard. He was the first finance minister of Pakistan after Martian Guard.
Yeah. Strong hand, but he never showed.